Caerhays Castle is surrounded by 140 acres of gardens. The Williams family have lived here for over 150 years, and today the castle is carefully looked after by Charles Williams, his wife Lizzie, and their housekeeper, Sian.
The Williams family, my family, bought the place in 1860, and as a family we've been here ever since. Well, the estate is, we have lots and lots of different businesses, ranging from plants by mail order to a building business, as well as farming, and we're open to the public.
Well, during the spring is our busiest time in the house. The gardens are beautiful. The house is open for about 3 months.
We like to think of ourselves as quite a big and dynamic, diverse business.
So, what's this then, storage?
Well, it's a, it was the
dumping ground.
It was the linen cupboard, but now it's sort of the entrance to the lift and a bit of a dumping ground.
So what's to go from here?
But the chair could go, potty cupboard, table.
You've got a lot of triangle stuff here, so 3 or 4 pieces of that, and the pedal cars and all of those bits. I'd be interested in all of the pedal cars, all of the tin stuff. They're in amazing condition. They don't look like they've been played with.
Is there a little ice cream van here you couldn't see?
Oh, well, that's another part of the...
Oh, look at that, yeah. Aren't they great? Not seen that before.
No.
Never seen that one before. In amazing condition. So whose were these? Were these yours?
They weren't mine. They were probably my brother's, I should think.
Straight away, I'm seeing a load of toys. Now, I buy lots and lots of toys, but generally for their decorative appeal. Old tin plate toys, all worn and that sort of thing. They're always attractive. But what we're seeing here is almost one make collection of matching toy trucks, which, well, I've not seen any as good as this before. They're like new. It would be unusual to find one, but to find a whole collection, that's really quite something.
These 7 vehicles range from an ice cream van to a train and trucks. They're made by American toy firm Tonka, founded in the 1940s, and the British toy makers Triang, created just after World War I. These toys are all from the mid-20th century and in mint condition. To a specialist collector or toy enthusiast, they could be worth around £1,100.
Do you have a figure in mind?
No, I have no idea.
I'm guessing as well. I'm thinking they've got to be worth £100 a piece at least, haven't they? Got to be worth that. £850
for the 7.
For the 7.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Deal. Marvellous. Thank you.
Drew now also wants to try and find some of the country house items that do so well for the business.
So this is to go. You're not using it at all.
No.
That's not bad. Castor's a little worn. Apart from that, that's okay. They're an odd one, these carpet chairs. Some people love them, some people hate them. I really quite like them. This table as well.
That's all right.
It's missing a piece.
Do you want a horse in your size?
I get this constantly. He's not actually any taller than me. Let's try and put a package together, maybe. The carpet armchair, it's of good quality with minor faults. I mean minor faults. It's got nice legs, it's a good colour. There is also a velvet-covered gypsy table. Quite a basic one. Pieces of furniture like this, they sort of come in and out of vogue. They're never worth a fortune. At the moment, I can't get enough of them. They're selling really well.
The late 19th century carpet chair and the Victorian gypsy table with its original velvet cover are more typical of the kind of items Drew usually buys. As classic examples of English country house furniture, they do really well on the website. They could fetch around £700 and £300 respectively. As an experienced dealer, Drew knows that doing a package deal can be the best way of getting a good price.
That's £180. Buy them all day long. And the chair, that would be £250.
Right.
Happy with that?
Yep.
For both of those?
For both of them, £180 and £250.
Marvellous, thank you.
Drew's done well on 2 deals so far, buying classic furniture that always sells well and unusual items he hadn't anticipated.
Can I have a look at that chair?
Sure.
Good shape. Really nice condition. I've not seen one in this condition. It's quite incredible. Again, it's almost like it's not been touched. And your family...
What does that say?
Mrs. Williams. Is that the name of the castle?
Glencoe. It's a place in Scotland.
This chair has never been used. It's never been sat in.
So this one's had loose covers over it from new, which a lot of them did.
You're about to see a little gem appear out of here.
Yeah, there you go. A brand new turn of the century. There's nowhere to the surface at all. There's nowhere to the casters. There's no chips to the leg. There's no damage whatsoever or anywhere to the webbing underneath. It's still got the paper label on it. It's never been used. I've never found one ever that's never been used. Exceptional. Does it make it more valuable? Yes, it does.
This unused chair is a surprising and rare find for Drew. It was made in the late 19th century, probably in Scotland, with a spoon or scooped back, low seat and armrests. This is a rare example of pristine, unused Victorian seating. It could be worth around £1,000.
£350.
It's got to be a bit more than that, isn't it, really?
What would you be happy with?
500.
Yeah, you don't get the opportunity very often, do you?
Okay.
Thank you.
Drew's racking up a great mix of items, and there's one last area for him to dig into.
Right, so what's this then? This is sort of museum.
Well, this is where we've accumulated
stuff.
Stuff.
There's a thing here that I like when we walked in. Let's have a quick look. The garden chairs are nice. Two of those. They should fold, but I think they've been welded up. They've got a lot of paint on those as well, haven't they?
They've been painted over the years, yeah.
Yeah. They're really nice. They're folding chairs.
Not in my era.
The paint is basically holding them together. There is something that I see straight away. Obviously, that is a pair of green folding metal garden chairs. Usually, that mesh on the back and the seat is like a chainmail. It's very flexible to sort of sit yourself in, and it's nice and comfortable-ish. These have got that much paint on them, they've completely frozen solid. There is no movement in those whatsoever. Age-wise, we are in the very, very last bit of the 19th century.
This set of garden chairs is late Victorian. The paint has seized up their folding mechanism, but they can be stripped back to their original frame and functionality. Their simple design, with the curled detailing in the arm and back, make them very saleable. As a pair, they could be worth around £900.
How does a couple of £100 grab you?
Well, can we do a bit better than that? Can we 300?
Can we meet in the middle? Can we meet at 250? That's just a lot of work.
Come on, three.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, well, they're a pair.
They're a pair.
Yeah, OK.
OK,
cheers. All right.
It's been a strong day of surprising finds for Drew.
Today was nice. I bought really well. I think the collection of Trian could do very well. I doubt there are many collections of that model, of those Trian toys from that period, in that condition. The condition's exceptional. Find of the day, if not the week or the month, was the brand new Scottish armchair. It's an antique, brand new chair. For me to be able to go into country houses like this and buy is very important to my business. I need to find a constant stock of all sorts of things.
And never in my wildest dreams did I ever think that those sorts of things would be worth the sort of money that we've been talking about today. He's got a very successful business. He knows what he wants. Some of the things he came out with were a revelation. It was quite an extraordinary day, wasn't it?
Right. We all done? Marvellous.
Yep.
Thank you very much.
Very good day.
Cheers.
I think that was enough.
Thank you.